Traction Waveform has many different ways to work with MIDI. In this tutorial, we'll cover how to record MIDI, edit MIDI on the piano roll, and automatically quantize MIDI events. In the previous video, we covered how to set up the program, the layout of all the settings and features, and how to record and edit audio. Make sure to check out those videos first. Also, before continuing, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is released. Regardless of whether we plan on manually adding MIDI on the piano roll or recording MIDI from a USB MIDI keyboard, the first thing we need to do is create an instrument track in Waveform. An instrument track takes MIDI inputs from a MIDI device or MIDI clip, runs it through an instrument like a synthesizer, and outputs audio to the master channel. MIDI on its own has no sound associated with it. It's just the instructions that go to an instrument to tell it what to do. First, start by creating a new track. We'll rename this track Synthesizer. Unlike other digital audio workstations, Waveform doesn't differentiate between audio and MIDI tracks when you're creating it. It will become an instrument track by putting MIDI on the track and an instrument in the plugins. The top right of the screen has a little plus button icon that can be used to add plugins to the tracks. We'll see this again in the next video when we go to add plugins to our program, but in this video it will be used to add the instrument to the track. Click and drag it onto the right side of the track just before the volume pan section. It needs to be to the left of the volume and panning control. Audio is processed in order from left to right on the track. If we put the plugin after the volume and panning control, then it wouldn't be able to control the instrument. By putting it before it, we can use the volume and panning controls. Under Waveform, go to Instruments and select 4OSC. This is the instrument plugin that's included with Waveform. I also have some extra instruments that were provided to me by Traction, and I've done videos in the past on this channel on free VST instruments to use in programs like Traction, so you can check those out if you need more instruments to use. At the top of the plugin, click the asterisk to bring up the presets and choose one to start with. As you get more familiar with Waveform, you can start to experiment with tweaking the sound by adjusting all the settings on the instrument itself, but for now we'll skip this and just choose a preset to get started. Close the instrument window for now and we'll go back to the track to create a MIDI clip. To create a clip, select the track with the instrument on it to get the properties up in the bottom center panel. This panel has a button we can use to insert a new clip, and from there we can select Insert New MIDI Clip. The clip will be created within the loop region that we used in the previous videos, so set those first. Unlike audio clips, MIDI clips can be extended easily by dragging the ends, and that gives it more length, since MIDI clips can just generate empty space that we can add events to. Now double-click on the new clip to open the piano roll. The piano roll is basically a grid that we can add MIDI notes to. The keyboard on the left side represents the notes, and the top is the time. The speed that it plays at will be determined by the length of the notes on the grid, and the tempo we set for the project in the first video. Before we start testing the piano roll, I recommend testing out the instrument to make sure our sound is playing. If we click and drag our mouse along the piano on the left side, then we should hear the notes generated as sound and the master channel level indicator will light up. This is also how we can test what the sound of our preset is. Let's start by covering how to navigate the piano roll. I like to start by grabbing the top edge of the piano roll and dragging it upwards to expand it. If we want to get rid of the piano roll, there's an X to close it in the top left. Then we can just bring it back again by double-clicking on the clip. The button next to that creates a separate window for the piano roll. To zoom in and out vertically on the piano, click and drag the arrows above and below the piano up or down. To move up or down vertically, use the scroll wheel on the mouse. To zoom in and out horizontally, use the mouse scroll wheel over the timeline at the top of the piano roll. To change the view, click and drag on this. Now let's cover the mouse tools. There are 6 mouse tools that can be switched with the buttons along the bottom of the piano roll. The first one is the pointer, which is a select tool to grab notes, drag and move them, and stuff like that. The next one is the pencil tool. This allows us to draw new notes by clicking and dragging. Line it up with the note on the piano roll you want to add, then click and drag at the time you want to add it for the length the note should be. The eraser removes notes by clicking on them. The line tool allows us to add a bunch of notes by clicking and dragging. The next button can be used to turn notes on and off. We can use this if we want to experiment with turning the note off, but not necessarily deleting it. Last is the button to preview the entire sound at a certain time for the notes that are at that time. The color panel to the right allows us to change the color of selected notes. Bell 127 is the velocity default value. Each note in MIDI has a velocity from 0 to 127. That can affect the volume of a note and actually the sound of how hard it sounds like it was hit, depending on how the particular synthesizer manages it. We can adjust the velocity of individual notes later, but this is the default for when we draw the notes in. The next is the default length if we add a note. When we add a note, it will start at this length, but we can click and drag it to change the length. Setting a default to the note that we use most often will make it easier for us. Step allows us to add notes at the cursor position by clicking the notes on the piano. The speaker button then lets us hear notes as we add them in. Transposing lets us change the pitch of all the notes at once. If we have notes selected by clicking and dragging a set of notes with the select tool, then only those notes are transposed. If no notes are selected, then all the notes are transposed for the entire clip. Quantize is used to snap the notes in time on the grid. When we record a MIDI instrument later, we'll see that the notes aren't always perfectly timed, and this depends on how good we are at playing the instrument. The Quantize tool fixes this all automatically based on settings for the resolution. We can also do this manually, but quantizing is a lot faster. The next tool is for groove, which is a kind of way of adjusting the timing. Timing can be loosened a bit from a perfectly divided measure to give it a little more groove and feel to the music. The Chords button is used to turn a single note into a chord. We select the note that will be the root of the chord, then use this button to create whatever type of chord we want, and it will automatically add the rest of the notes for the correct length onto the piano roll. So that basically covers the piano roll for now. We'll come back to it again in a minute, but let's get to recording a MIDI keyboard. First, we'll need to enable our MIDI device in Waveform. Go to the Settings menu at the top of the program, and then go to MIDI Devices. Make sure your MIDI device is turned on and connected to the computer over USB. If it shows up, we can click on it to enable it. If it doesn't, press the button to refresh the MIDI device list after ensuring it's properly connected, then enable it. For my MIDI controller, I'm using an Akai MPK249. This is a 49-key MIDI keyboard with 16 drum pads. It also has 8 faders, knobs, and switches to use as a control surface. This is a great MIDI controller for composing, and it's also really useful for automation, as we'll see in a few videos. For more information on how to get one for yourself, check out the links in the video description or the full review and tutorial of this MIDI controller on the channel. With the MIDI controller enabled, go back to the project at the top. Change the input on the track to MPK249. This is done exactly the same as when we set it as an audio input. The MIDI input will be below the audio inputs from the audio interface. Then arm the track for recording and press the record button to record a new MIDI clip on that track. Make sure to have the click track enabled so you can play it in time with the project. This is really important for MIDI, especially since we need to adjust the timing of the notes later on. Once the MIDI clip is recorded, click on it to open the piano roll. Like we saw earlier, we can use the select tool to move notes around manually, either by pitch or time, and adjust their length. We can add notes that we may have missed or erase notes that we hit by accident. Click the velocity button to bring up the velocity controls. We get a velocity bar for each note. Click and drag the top of the velocity bar to increase or decrease the velocity. Now we can look at quantization. If we click the quantize button, we get an option to quantize by start and end times and the length of the note. Choose which way you want to quantize, then click it and select a note resolution. Select the note resolution for the fastest part of the clip. Don't use a shorter time than notes that you have, or it's more likely it will snap the wrong way. After we've used quantization, make sure to play it all back to be sure all the notes have snapped to the right position. If there are a few notes that have snapped wrong, use the select tool to drag them to the correct position. The last thing we should cover for MIDI is the Micro Drum Sampler. If you don't have any other drum plugins to use, first of all, we have a video on some of the free plugins that are available. This new version of Traction Waveform comes with a Micro Drum Sampler with two built-in kits. We can also create new kits by dragging and dropping electronic drum sample files onto the pads. From here, we can input a beat on the piano roll, or we can add notes with a MIDI controller. This is where I can use the MIDI drum pads on my keyboard to input notes, and they're great for creating a beat since they're also velocity sensitive. The default settings probably won't line up with the MIDI inputs from the drum pad you're using, and it's easy to set this up right so that it matches what we see on the screen. The screen shows a 4x4 pad, and that's the same as my drum pad. There's a MIDI Learn button along the bottom that we can use to set this. Click this button, then click a pad in the plugin on the screen, followed by the pad on the USB MIDI controller. Match up each of the pads, then turn off MIDI Learn. Now you can drum with everything set up properly. For the rest of the controls, the top knob is to control the volume of all the samples. The bottom menu lets us change the icon and color of the drum icon. The play button plays the sample. Then we have the name and associated MIDI note. The next three knobs are for volume, panning, and velocity sensitivity. Finally, the last two buttons are to solo and mute the sample. So at this point, we've covered all the MIDI controls in Traction Waveform to create MIDI and edit it. Whether you're using the piano roll or a MIDI keyboard, you should be able to do whatever you need to in this program. Thanks for checking out this video on recording and editing MIDI in Traction Waveform. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for products featured in this video and social media links.